नेक्स्ट टॉपिक रिलेशन बिटवीन फोकल लेंथ एंड रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर So this is the topic. First of all, focal length is denoted by letter small f and radius of curvature is denoted by letter capital R. So we are going to derive the relation between small f and capital R, that is relation between focal length and radius of curvature. For this I am taking one concave mirror. How you say that this is a concave mirror? A spherical mirror. Inside is reflecting surface. So this is the reflecting surface towards the center of the hollow sphere. This is the center of the hollow sphere. The reflecting surface is towards the center of the hollow sphere. And outside of the spherical mirror is polished surface. This is the polished surface. So inside of the curved mirror, reflecting surface, outside is polished surface. We can say that is a concave mirror. Okay. This is a type of spherical mirror. Now, where is the pole of the spherical mirror? Center of the curved surface. This is the curved surface. The center of the curved surface is called pole. So, this is the pole. Next, where is the principal axis? Principal axis is passing between pole to center of curvature. Where is the center of curvature? The center of the hollow sphere. This is a hollow sphere. So this is the center of the hollow sphere. So this is a center of curvature. A straight line passing from pole to center of curvature, that is called principal axis. So this is the principal axis. When you place the object here, what happened? The incident tracer passing through principal axis. This is the principal axis, parallel rays. Those are incident rays passing through the reflective surface. After what happened? These are the incident rays. This is a reflected ray. Meet a focus on principal axis. This is a focus on principal axis, principal axis line. So focus, principal focus is denoted by a letter capital F. This is the capital F. If you extended this line, this is the reflecting line. This is a ray, incident A, B. This is a point B. The distance between principal focus to pole is focal length. So distance between up to here, f, small f, that is focal length. Next, the distance between center of curvature to pole is radius of curvature. So this is the R. Now, derive the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. For this, I am drawing a normal line between incident ray and reflected ray. This is the normal line. Okay. So, your angle is I here angle is R. Instant ray with instant angle I, reflected ray with angle small r. Here angle is alpha. Okay, why we are drawing here normal line? We are already studied laws of reflection. There is a rule, instant ray and reflectant ray normal line are in same medium. Instant ray is travel towards the normal line and reflected ray is emits from normal line. So that we are drawing a normal line between instant ray and reflected ray. According to laws of reflection, angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. So angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. That is the first equation. From the diagram, observe that PC is the principal axis. PC is the principal axis. This line is equal to incident ray AB because both distance are same. Okay, so principal axis PC equal to AB from the diagram. This is a normal line, here angle I, here angle alpha. If suppose these two lines are equal, so what happened? Angle of I is equal to angle of alpha. Angle of I equal to angle of alpha. If suppose AB line is equal to PC line, so the angle of incident and angle of alpha both are equal. This is the equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, what we write? Angle I is equal to angle or angle I equal to angle alpha, so that angle alpha equal to angle R equal to angle alpha. Angle of reflection is equal to angle of alpha. From this, what we are understanding? So angle of R is equal to angle of alpha. So these two angles are equal. This is a triangle BCF. Triangle BCF. Two angles are equal. Then the triangle is called isosceles triangle. So triangle BCF is called isosceles triangle. BCF is called isosceles triangle. Why? Because two angles of a triangle is equal, so that triangle is named as a isosceles triangle. According to isosceles triangle, two angles are equal, two sides also equal. So two sides means CF equal to FB. So two angles are equal. So in isosceles triangle, two sides are equal. CF equal to BF or FB. Consider a small aperture. Aperture means light is entering to reflecting surface. This is the aperture. This aperture will decreases. What happened? Suppose this is, I am taking as a B point. So what happened? This aperture will be decreases. So what happened? The line CB is equal to CP. If aperture is decreases, so CB line is equal to CP. For small aperture, what happened? The line PF means principal axis is equal to FB. CF equal to FB, FB equal to PF. So we can write CF equal to PF because PF equal to FB, CF equal to FB. PF equal to FB, CF equal to FB. We can write CF equal to PF. From the diagram, CP equal to CF plus FP. From the diagram, CF equal to CF plus PF. From the diagram, so CP equal to CF plus FP. So FP means small f, CP means capital R. CF equal to PF. So TP equal to CF equal to PF plus PF. So CP equal to CF plus PF. So CF equal to PF. So PF plus PF. So CP equal to R. PF equal to F. CP equal to R, PF equal to small f plus small f 2F capital R equal to. So capital R equal to 2F, small f equal to R by 2. That is the relation between focal length and radius curvature. Small f equal to capital R by 2. Very, very important formula. From this, what we are understanding? Focal length is equal to radius of curvature divided by 2. If you want focal length value, radius of curvature is given. So if you want focal length value, what happened? Small f equal to capital R value by 2. That is the focal length value. So focal length small f equal to capital R by 2. That is the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Sometimes same question asking in your board exam, prove that F equal to R by 2. Prove that F equal to R by 2 means same focal length and radius curvature, relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Once I am going to repeating, according to laws of reflection, angle of incident equal to angle of reflection. This is the normal line. Why we are drawing the normal line? According to laws of reflection, we are drawing a normal line between incident ray and reflected ray. Principal axis, this is the principal axis, PC equal to incident ray AP. So here PC and AB angles are, this is the I angle, this is the alpha angle. So this is the incident angle, this is the normal angle. Angle of incident equal to angle of alpha, because both lines are parallel. That's why we are taking angle of incident equal to angle of alpha. So angle of incident equal to angle of alpha. From equation 1 and 2, what we write? Angle of reflection equal to angle of alpha. Okay. This is a triangle BCF. In this triangle, angle of I equal to angle of R means these two angles are equal. In a triangle, two angles are equal, then the triangle is named as isosceles triangle. In the isosceles triangle, two angles are equal, then two sides of the triangle is equal. So CF equal to FP. So CF equal to FV. This is the aperture of the concave mirror. BP is the aperture of the concave mirror. If you decrease the aperture, means so B is come to here, so aperture is decreases. So if you decrease the aperture, what happened? AB is equal to BF line. Okay, PF and BF, both lines are comes close together. So PF equal to BF. For a small aperture, PF line is equal to FB line. PF equal to FB, CF is equal to FB. From that, what we are understanding? PF equal to FB, CF equal to FB. So PF equal to CF. PF equal to CF or CF equal to PF. That is the CF equal to PF. From the diagram, CP is the principal axis. So CP equal to CF plus FP. So CP equal to CF plus PF. Okay. CP equal to CF equal to, we can write PF. So CP equal to PF plus PF. So PF value, focal length small f. So F plus F. CP is the radius curvature, capital R. So R equal to 2F. So small f is the focal length equal to radius of curvature by 2. That is the relation between radius of curvature and focal length. Small f equal to R.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.